Hello everyone, this is Usha. My technical seminar topic is on YouTube data analysis using Hadoop MapReduce under the guidance of Chandrasekhar KT. So we'll start with the introduction of Hadoop. So what actually Hadoop is? Hadoop is a large scale open source software framework which can handle thousands of nodes and petabytes of data. So this is the diagram which explains about the Hadoop. Hadoop runs applications using the MapReduce algorithm where the data is processed in parallel with others. That is, Hadoop is used to develop applications that could perform complete statistical analysis on huge amounts of data. So what the objective of this Hadoop is, the most common problems that can be solved using Hadoop, and what are the types of analysis can be performed using Hadoop, and actually where the data comes from, and what are the benefits of analyzing all the data using Hadoop. The motivation is what the problems are exist with the traditional scales and what are the requirements that an alternative approach can handle, and whether those can be addressed by Hadoop or not. This is the architecture of Hadoop. So here it contains two major layers, that is processing or computational layer, which we call it as MapReduce. And the second one is storage layer, which we'll call it as HDFS. It is Hadoop Distributed File System. So we'll go with MapReduce and HDFS in detail. So what actually HDFS is? HDFS is based on the Google File System and provides a distributed file system that is designed to run on commodity hardware. And about the MapReduce, MapReduce is a parallel programming model for writing the distributed applications devised at a Google for efficient processing of large amounts of data on a large clusters of commodity hardware. So we'll start with the HDFS overview. HDFS is based on the Google file systems and provides a distributed file system that is designed to run on commodity hardware, and it has many similarities with existing distributed file systems. However, the differences from other distributed file systems are significant, and it is highly fault tolerant and designed to be deployed on a low cost hardware. It provides high throughput access to applications data and is suitable for applications having large data sets. And the HDFS holds very large amount of data and provides easier access to them. And it can store such a huge data that files stored across multiple machines. We'll see what are the features of HDFS. So the first one is, it is suitable for the distributed storage and processing. And the second one is, Hadoop provides a command interface to interact with HDFS. And the built-in servers of name node and data node help users to easily check the status of the clusters. Streaming access to a file system data, and the last one is HDFS provides the file permissions and authentications also. So this is the architecture of HDFS, which contains the elements like name node, data node and block. So we'll go in detail with all elements. So first we'll start with the name node. So what actually name node does is, the name node is the commodity hardware that contains the Linux or operating system and the name node software. It is a software that can be run on commodity hardware. The system having the name node acts as a master server, and it does the following tasks like manages the file system namespace, regulates the client's access to files, and it also executes the file system operations such as renaming, closing and opening the files and directories. The next one is data node. So we'll see what actually data node does is, the data node is commodity hardware having the Linux operating system as the previous one that name node had, and data node software. First of all, every node in a cluster, there will be a data node, and these nodes will be managing the data storage of these systems. So the data nodes performed read-write operations on the file systems as per client request, and they also perform the operations such like block creations, deletions and replications according to the instructions of the name node. So the last element which the HDFS has is the block. So the generally block, the user data is stored in the files of HDFS. So these files in a file system will be divided into one or more segments and stored in a individual data nodes. So these file segments will be called as a blocks. In other words, or in other sentences, as how can we see what actually block is? The minimum amount of data that HDFS can read or write is called as block. The default block size is 64 MB, but it can be increased as per the need of changes in the HDFS configurations. So the next one is MapReduce. So as I said, these are the components of the Hadoop. So we have already discussed about HDFC. We'll go through the MapReduce. So what actually MapReduce is all about? MapReduce is a processing technique and a program model for distributed computing based on Java. So the MapReduce algorithm contains two important task of functions like map and reduce. So map, what actually map does is map takes a set of data and converts into the another set of data where the individual elements are broken down into tuples. We can call it as leaf key or value pairs, that is tuples. And secondly, the reduce task, that is reduce function, which takes all these output from a map as an input and combines those data to tuples into a smaller set of tuples. So as the sequence of the name map reduce implies, the reduce task is always performed after the map job. So we'll start with the literature survey. So here I have taken three papers for the reference of the YouTube data analysis. So we'll start with the first one. The first one is data analysis using Hadoop MapReduce environment, which is all talked about the YouTube data analysis. As I said, my topic is on YouTube data analysis using Hadoop MapReduce. So we'll talk about it later. The second one is big data analysis of Indian Premier League using Hadoop and MapReduce. So this is here they have taken Twitter as an example instead of a YouTube, as the previous page or the previous paper had the YouTube data analysis. Here they have taken a Twitter as an example for this. The third one is distributed pattern matching and document analysis using big data Hadoop MapReduce model. Here it is all about the pattern matching and document analysis using the same model. So we'll start with the design model or design method. So this topic deals with the analysis of YouTube data using Hadoop MapReduce framework on a cloud platform AWS, that is Amazon Web Service. So analysis of large scale data sets has been a challenging task, but with the advent of Apache Hadoop, the data processing is done at very high speed. So what we are doing here is, in this project, we have collected the video statistics from YouTube API, and the statistics includes attributes like video ID, uploader views, length, comments and ratings, etc. So this data is filtered and then stored in HDFS, that is Hadoop Distributed File System. Apache Hadoop provides MapReduce framework, which is popularly used programming model for analyzing the large data sets. So this is the system model. So it explains how the YouTube data analysis will be done using this model. So here we have the components like YouTube API, Hadoop cluster in AWS, HDFS, that is Hadoop Distributed File System, and Hadoop framework, which is here MapReduce is a framework. So for our system, we firstly fetch YouTube data, that is video ID, uploader, age, category, length, views, ratings, comments, etc., and we'll store it in our HDFS using YouTube APIs. This data is further processed by our mapper class, and the output will be stored in a local file system. Then reducer class further applies our business logic on this locally intermediate data and processes it. So the final output will be finally stored in HDFS again. So experimental study is here. What we are doing here is we are going to take the top most five categories in which the most number of videos are uploaded, and the second one is the top five uploaders and the top five most viewed videos. So what would be the result of this is, the results would be, results of analysis are shown in graphical format using the pie charts and bar graphs. The top five trending video categories are listed in a pie chart with the different colors for each different category, namely in entertainment, films and animations, music, people and blogs, and education. So along with this pie chart, a table list is shown with the most trending video at the top of the list, that is displaying the category name and total number of videos in the category. So the top 5 uploaders with the highest number of videos uploaded in displayed in a bar graph showing the count of videos. So, and also top 5 trending videos with the highest views are listed in a tabular format. All these statistics helps in understanding the data analysis of YouTube in a simpler format. Application is, it uses for Google Maps using MapReduce. For example, like finding the nearest feature to given address or current locations and all. And some existing users of this Hadoop is Facebook, Yahoo, Amazon, eBay, Google, IBM, the New York Times and all. These are the existing users of this model. Conclusion, if you talk about conclusion, it would be like data analysis plays an important role in determining business and marketing strategies. So this project can help or can play a key role in helping the advertising enterprise to identify the most trending category and invest on those video categories only, so that the YouTube Data API is useful to retrieve the data from the website and then process it in a Hadoop MapReduce environment. And these are the references which I have taken for this model of analyzing of YouTube data. Thank you.